Hello, and thanks for tuning in. If you're new to the channel, please hit the subscribe button. If you're returning, thanks, it means a lot. This video is continuing on to show how you would take your base map and burn it to a chip. If you haven't watched the previous videos, click the link above. It'll bring you back to the first video that you should watch in the series all the way till now. So in the last video, we made a base map simple for a D16 Z6, stock motor, stock injectors, just basically your basic tune to get you started and running so you can start reading your parameters. Once you have it, you have an option. You can save it to your computer, or HCS makes it simple and they have a feature under file. You go to chip and you can read, write, or verify your chip. So we want to write the file to the chip. So you're going to have some type of burner or an emulator. If you want me to do a video on the emulator, drop a comment below. I do have an emulator and I can show that. Right now I'm using a chip burner, so we know it's an SST chip. I know it's a 64KB chip, and we're going to write it. So this is basically going to take this file that we made and burn it to this chip so we can put it in the ECU. So we hit write, and it's going to detect it. We basically erased it, detecting it, and that will turn green if it's good. The write will light up green. So there it is, it was successful write to the chip. So any data that's on the chip, if it ain't blank, will get erased when you do this. So once you get the green write button and the green bar all the way across the bottom, you can close it and then you can come back and you can verify your chip to make sure that it actually burned properly and the ECU is gonna be able to read it. So we're gonna verify chip, same thing, SST, 64, verify. It's gonna do the same thing, green bar, green verify. You know that it's good. There you go. All right, at this point, you successfully burned the map that you made to a chip, and you can go insert it in your OBD1 Honda ECU and start the vehicle. Now, there is another way to do this. It involves going to Moat's website and downloading flash and burn, downloading the drivers, and that gives you a little more options with the chips. I think you can burn GM chips and all that stuff with it, but you basically have to have a chip burner at a minimum and a SST chip to get the file off the computer or an emulator. And like I said, if you guys want any more information on any of those products or how I do it, other than that, just drop a comment below. Tell me exactly what you want. That'll give me some feedback and an idea of what videos you guys want to see. But it's really not that hard to get the base map onto a chip. You've seen it basically 2 minutes and we were done. So the next video, I will go into putting the chip into the ECU and basically starting it up on the bench and running a simulator, an ECU simulator, and showing you guys how to data log and get in there and look at some of the parameters. So I appreciate all the support like always. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe.